This is the beginning. It starts right here. Thomas, welcome to Sapphire. We are glad to have you.
Thanks for having me. It's a privilege to be with all of you. You know, we have this amazing collaboration with SAP, going back 5 years now. Most people probably don't realize we have three parts to our relationship. Mm-hmm. And our engineering teams work very closely together. We built many, many things together, scale out, live migration. We're going to talk more about data today, AI. And we're helping hundreds of customers migrate to the cloud and use the RISE program for the business transformation. Second important thing, Alphabet, the parent of Google, is one of SAP's global customers. We run a whole company on S4. We run simple. We run it on a cloud. And it's been 11 quarters, and we've never had a single second of outage or problem. We consolidate 50 billion transactions a month, multiple terabytes of data, and our CFO is one of Christian's fans. So second example of us working together. And third, we work with so many of your SAP teams in engineering, so it's a privilege to be here, and thank you to all the teams at SAP that work so closely with us.
Yeah, Thomas, I guess it's, first of all, you made many people here happy, really, at SAP. Looking at smiling Thomas. And of course, we're also keeping our engineering teams pretty busy, you know, to the benefit of our customers. Now, we expanded our partnership. Just a few days ago, we announced that SAP Datasphere will run on GCP as part of RISE with SAP. We're going to break the data silos by bringing SAP and Google Cloud data together. Yes. Tell us a bit more, Thomas, where do you see the value of our joint customers?
You know, bringing the data together is a key part of business transformation. And, you know, getting a unified view of data, both internal and external, is a critical part to the RISE program and the business transformation. So think about if you're a retailer and you're trying to plan inventory, you need to get a view of search trends on Google because it's typically a great predictor to what kind of products people may buy. If you're in sustainability, you have your own products, but you need a view of where you're sourcing, for example, water from to manufacture or raw materials. And Google's Earth Engine, for example, is used by many, many companies to do that. If you're in supply chain, you're trying to get a view of what logistics disruptions may cause delays in you getting parts and inventory in order to run a just-in-time manufacturing system. So what we've done with SAP is to make it trivial to migrate data from SAP Datasphere into Google's BigQuery system, where you can enrich from external sources and run analytics that can be surfaced back in SAP. It makes it better, because you get not just your own information, but enriched information. Faster, we can replicate using BTP transactions in real time. Simpler, because you can see it both in the analytical system and within SAP applications. And then we put a lot of security controls around it to protect and keep this data secure. We have over 300 customers now using this solution, including Google ourselves. We run all of our ERP analysis on top of this, and we've seen great value being delivered to many clients.
Yeah, and Thomas, just to build on that, I don't meet hardly any customer who's not telling me that while they need to make fast and agile decisions, there are hundreds of people in the back while you're looking into the digital boardroom who still manually need to touch the data, making sure that customer A is the same customer in one system and in another system. And I guess this is what this partnership is about, solving this challenge. Now, we are talking also a lot about AI.
Yes.
Everyone has big dreams, big hopes about what AI can do for their business. But even the most sophisticated algorithms and chatbots need high quality data.
Yes.
So what can this partnership do about delivering real value out of AI?
You know, the most important thing to make sure your algorithms, if you put garbage in, you get garbage out of the algorithms, right? And how many of you say, I want to have fragmented data? How many of you say, I'd really like to have no consistent view of any of it? No one. The great thing about SAP and Google with AI and data is we're already solving real problems for real customers. We made shopping and commerce much easier using AI for discovery for companies like IKEA. We've made the ability for Home Depot to have a unified view of all of their inventory so that they don't have stockouts because of the combination of the data platform and AI on top of it. If you're in Argentina at Mercado Libre, a very, very large retailer, not only have we helped them use our AI to predict where products are needed, but also to cut down their logistics and to speed up and make their logistics network much easier. For them, it's a big part of their sustainability initiatives. We're helping Ford identify and predict quality issues in cars, even when they're being manufactured, by putting our AI on top of BTP, SAP, which runs their infrastructure, and our analytics platform. So all of these are real examples of real AI being used, whether it's in manufacturing, in supply chain, in commerce, in the customer interface. And then most importantly, we have over 100 million customers at Alphabet, tracking things like accounts payable, predicting cash flow, making sure we have a good view as the economy changes on what accounts balances look like. We use AI to predict all of it. So in every day, we have many customers using the work that our teams have done together to solve real problems that help with the business transformation agenda, which is powering RISE.
Yeah, so Thomas, actually, I wanted to go a little bit off script and ask you about the happiness of Alphabet as a customer. We already covered that. Now, there's nothing left for me just to say thank you, and I really mean it. Whenever there is a customer asking for support as part of RISE with SAP, new scale-out scenarios, new virtual machines we need to support, no matter if we need to scale the business globally, we need new data centers in certain parts of the world, you are there. The best thing about this partnership is, this here is the nice stuff. What really happens behind the scenes is that our engineering teams are coming together to make this a real value-add story for our customers. For that, I would love to thank you, Thomas. Thanks for coming to Orlando. I wish you all the best.
Thank you for having me. Thank you all.